new year, my friend. I am so pumped to welcome you on my channel in a brand new year 2019, and I hope you had a great start, whether that's been being cozy at home with friends or partying the night away. Now I'm so excited for this year because this year I'm starting my own company, helping you to move abroad and have a wonderful abroad experience. So stay tuned for that. More to come in the near future. Now, if that's your plan, if you decided to move abroad this year or in the near future, then this video is for you because I have three killer questions for you. And they are kind of deep that you should answer before you move abroad to prepare, to have a great experience, to kill it and have the success you want. Sounds like a plan? Let's do this. Also, make sure to watch till the end because this week I have a special bonus for you and I'm so excited for it. Okay, so the first question is, what is my why? What is my motivation? As Simon Sinek would say, start with why. And same thing goes for moving abroad. So what is your why? Why are you moving abroad? Do you want more job opportunities or you're striving for a better quality of life? If that's the case, wonderful. Or is it because you are not quite satisfied with your life back home? Because you're not so happy as you want to be? If that's the case, you might think twice. And don't get me wrong, I totally get it. Now, every now and then we need a change. We need an opportunity to get away from our problems and give us a fresh start. And that's okay. But if you're running away from your problems, know that's not a solution and you can't really run away from them. So let me explain. And let's use the example of relationships because, well, everyone has relationships in their life and they're an important part of our lives. And so I'm sure you heard this one. You want to be happy and find a partner who is happy to have a happy relationship. Right? So if you are looking for a partner to complete you or to make you happy, that's most of the time not what's going to happen because even though now you're in a relationship, you're still not quite happy. And the same goes for moving abroad. So you want to have a strong enough why, strong enough motivation to keep you going. So whatever happens, you feel frustrating, homesick, or things aren't going the way you planned it, so that you can look back and see why you did it and decided it in the first place. Now, the second question is, what expectations do you have? What do you expect from your time abroad? And let's be honest about this one. Do you want to find a job within the first month and perform from the first day on, or do you want to learn German like this? Now, it's great to have these goals and I fully support you and I'm so excited for you that you have them. On the other hand, my experience from working with hundreds of experts over the period of the last years is that sometimes we expect too much from ourselves. In the beginning, in the first several months, you will need time to settle in, to figure out your routines again and to feel like you have control over your life again. And that doesn't happen overnight. And what's important is that you also plan time for self-care so that you feel good. And what happens is, or what I'm trying to say is that you don't expect too much within a very short period of time because this kind of a pressure even worsens the situation. So if you're already overwhelmed by the newness, it's only going to amplify. So make sure your expectations are realistic. Learning language at the same time as looking for a job or trying to feel at home in a new country, that's so much newness that our brain cannot really process it. So all you can do, if you want to do it in a sustainable way, and what I mean by that is not getting burnout after 1 month or deciding to go back home after several weeks, is that you take baby steps and that you are happy doing these baby steps and progressing at your own time. Now, the third one is, what has to happen for me to be happy with my abroad time? What has to happen in order for you to feel like this time that you spent abroad or spending abroad is successful and that you are happy about the outcomes? And what should be the outcome anyway? And of course, having the experience of living abroad is always enriching. So whatever happens, even though you planned something and didn't quite work out, you can always learn something out of that. So once you are clear on the vision for your time abroad and how it fits into your long-term vision, overall life's vision of yours, then you can go backwards and plan and set your goals accordingly. Now, let's say that your plan is to master German on a level that you feel like you've integrated, because you can have random conversations with it at work or at home and you feel comfortable, you feel like you are almost a local. Now, if that's a goal of yours, then of course what you need to do is to think, okay, if I wanna make it happen within the next year, which would be very ambitious, within the next 2 years, what this needs to happen in order for me to reach the goal? So how many classes do I need to take a week? What form, what kind of a format is the best for me? Is it the one-on-ones or is it the group training? What are all the things that I need to do in order to achieve this goal? This question is going to give you clarity, first and above, about what you want. And second, it will help you figure out what has to happen in order to achieve it. Now, if you want to dive right in and answer these questions for yourself, I prepared for you a tiny little very useful sheet that you can start working on right now, and you can find the link in the description. I hope it helps. Now, I would love to hear from you. So what are your answers to these questions? I'm so curious to hear about your why and your expectations and your goals. What are they? Let us know in the comment section below. I'm sure this is also helpful for others who are about to move abroad or move to Austria as well. Let's talk in the comments below. Also, if you enjoyed this video, if you found it helpful, give me a like, subscribe to my channel and share with those who might need it. Thank you guys so much for watching. And again, Happy New Year, guys. I hope you have a great one and I see you next week.